Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Morning Markets, where the team at True Potential discuss the key themes over the past 24 hours in asset markets and how that impacts your investments. Today, we're going to focus in on the Federal Reserve and their announcement yesterday. So, turning to the Fed, what did we get yesterday? We got the first indications of how they were thinking about their revised policy framework, that move to average inflation targeting. The details that we received yesterday were, I suppose, very much in line with expectations, in the sense that the Fed's projection for interest rates are to remain very low at similar levels today for the longer term. And indeed, the dot plot that indicates how the FOMC members are thinking about that suggests that interest rates won't change out until 2023, so a considerable period of time of low rates ahead. They also discussed the accommodative stance of monetary policy that is there and will remain in place until inflation can meaningfully achieve the 2% target that they've set on an average basis. So I think interpreting that, it means that over time, the Fed are trying to get inflation expectations to move higher to that 2% level. Something that will be interesting to see if that can be achieved, just given when we look back over the past number of years when they had a target of 2%, inflation didn't hit 2%. So how in this new environment do we get to that level? Implication being that inflation would need to run materially above 2% for a period of time to bring that average into play. Also, the Fed talked positively about the economic recovery that's ongoing in the US. They revised a number of their current year expectations in terms of GDP growth, in terms of unemployment, to better numbers than they had previously thought about. So GDP contraction this year, some 3.7% is now their estimates, that compared to June, where they were talking about a contraction of 6.5%. So that gives you an indication of the magnitude of improvement there. The Fed also noted the need for fiscal support and the crucial role that fiscal support has played in helping the US economy heal from the impact of COVID-19. Interestingly, as we've discussed in this many times, that is somewhat stuck in Congress at this point in time, with Democrats and Republicans not wanting to move forward. President Trump last night gave some tacit endorsement to a revised bill of some $1.5 trillion of additional fiscal support. Both Democrats, Republicans push back on that. So it's going to be interesting to see if we can actually get anything done here ahead of the election. In terms of asset market responses yesterday to the Fed, clearly Europe was closed. In the US, we saw equity markets initially move higher, and then as the afternoon wore on, they sold off, with both the Nasdaq and the S&P 500 closing weaker for the day. And indeed, that weakness has flowed into Asian equity markets today. In the bond market, we saw bond yields increase a little bit, so bonds selling off a little over the course of the day. So the 10-year yield moved up maybe 2 basis points overall. The currency markets, I think it was interesting, however, to note that the dollar did strengthen on the back of the announcements and that little bit of movement in equity and bond markets. So that'll be something to watch over the coming days. The implication being that with higher inflation, it would lead to potentially a weakening of the currency. So just interesting to see that mismatch yesterday in the reaction in markets, but more of that over the coming days. Other things yesterday, just retail sales in the US for August, they came in up 0.6% month on month. That was a little bit below where the market had been thinking. Probably closer to 1% was where expectations sat. Important to think about that in the context of the unemployment numbers that we've seen, that rate of improvement slowing, and some of the indicators that on the margin maybe indicate why a revision or a revised fiscal support package is required. So again, that merits monitoring over the coming weeks. Turning to today, what we'll be looking at, well, we've got the Bank of England MPC meeting with the press conference and details being released at 12 o'clock. No changes expected there on either policy side or on the asset purchase program. But what may come of that is just their forecasts and their thoughts about the shape of the UK recovery, and also any of their thoughts leading into the final quarter of the year and the implications of Brexit and the ongoing discussions there, and what that might mean for the economy, the additional support that might need to be provided by the Bank of England. So we'll reflect on that tomorrow. That's it for today. If you're finding the morning markets useful, please do like it and subscribe on YouTube. We'll see you again tomorrow. Many thanks. Bye.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and don't forget to subscribe to the True Potential YouTube channel. If you have any questions or requests for future videos, let us know in the comments.